So in a previous video, I showed you how to start up my helicopter, which is an Enstrom 280C built in 1978. It's a little low-tech, but it does get the job done. So the bigger question is, once you have the helicopter running, how do you fly it? That was one of the comments that people noted. It's like, okay, well, so what do I do now that the engine's running? We're going to go through all the controls. There are three main controls. Oh, and I've added a second camera angle because we're just that advanced out here in the old 1978 helicopter. So three main controls. There's the cyclic, which is this one right here. There's the collective, which you may not be able to see on this angle right down here, but you'll see it in a second when I pull it up. And then there are the anti-torque pedals, which I operate with my feet. And you can watch them over there as I move them back and forth. Let's talk about how each of those works. So the main one, let's talk about the collective. This is the one that makes the helicopter go up and down. Basically, it increases the pitch of the blades collectively. So anywhere they are in their point of rotation, if I lift this up, it's going to increase their pitch and create more lift. So let's lift up and see what happens when I pull up on that collective. Also, I'm here, so you'll hear some background radio traffic action, but we'll just ignore that. So I'm going to lift up on the collective right now. We're on a pad, lifting up, and there we go. Now we're up in the air. So I got a little bit of pitch in the blades here, and we're hovering. And you'll notice I have to make constant adjustments. We'll talk about why I have to make constant adjustments in a little bit. So this one's pretty simple. Just makes the helicopter go up and down. That's called the collective. The one that I'm operating with my right hand is called the cyclic. The cyclic changes the pitch of the blades cyclically. So at different points in their rotation around the helicopter, say if they're at the nose versus the tail, the pitch will change. It'll be lower at the nose and higher at the tail, or lower on the right and higher on the left. What that does is that allows the rotor disc to tilt in one direction or another. So if I pull back on the cyclic,
runway 26 left.
Look, we're moving backwards. That seems very simple. And then if I move to the left, watch, we'll crawl a little bit to the left here. And now I'm going to go to the right, moving a little bit to the right. Now you notice it's not as simple as just moving the stick to the right or moving the stick to the left. The entire time you're flying here in a hover, you're making these little minute adjustments because helicopters are inherently unstable. So that's, I guess, the fun part. They say that there are some natural-born airplane pilots, but there are no natural-born helicopter pilots, and this is why, because everything needs constant adjustment. Okay, the last controls are the anti-torque pedals. Why are they called anti-torque pedals? Because when I lift up on the collective, that adds more power to the main rotor, and I have to counteract that with the pedals. And as I lower the collective, I have to counteract that as well. In a helicopter like this, where the blades spin counterclockwise, when I lift up the collective and add power, that adds power to the main rotor and creates torque that has to be counteracted by the tail rotor. So that means I add left pedal to counteract that. And it's the exact opposite. When I lower the collective and reduce power to the main rotor, I add right pedal. The one complicating factor in my helicopter is that, unlike every other single modern helicopter, it lacks a governor. And what a governor does is it keeps the rotor spinning at a preset speed. So you might not know it, but helicopters, when they fly, the blades just spin at a consistent speed, a very narrow green RPM range. So in this helicopter, I have to do that manually. So as I lift up the collective, I actually have to roll on throttle like a motorcycle twist grip here. It's right here on the edge of the end of the collective. So basically, I've got four controls, but there are three main controls: anti-torque pedals, cyclic, and the collective. So the thing about flying a helicopter is that there's no set it and forget it. Oh, good, I'm stable. The whole thing's inherently unstable, and then there are complications. So if a little breeze comes from the right side, and I have to counteract that to keep the nose straight by adjusting the anti-torque pedals, that changes how much power the tail rotor is using, which means I have to adjust the throttle. And when I adjust the throttle, it changes how much power is going to the main rotor, so I have to further change the anti-torque pedals. And everything affects everything else. If I lift up collective, I have to add left pedal, and left pedal pushes the entire helicopter to the right because the anti-torque pedals are spinning, and so I have to add left cyclic. This sounds really complicated, and the fact is, it is. That's why you can't just watch a YouTube video and then go fly a helicopter. You really do need proper training. And so you should do that. I wouldn't rely on this. All that said, if you find yourself in a zombie apocalypse scenario and you've watched the previous video and you know how to start up an Enstrom 280C helicopter and you want to make your escape, give it a go. If you got nothing to lose, sure, try the controls. It's a big boatload of fun. So now here, I'm just going to talk through a couple of light maneuvers. So I'm adding a little left pedal and moving the tail over that direction. I'm facing the blinding sun, which is really annoying. Let's see. You notice all these little cyclic adjustments. The rotor basically functions like a gyroscope, and it always kind of wants to tilt off in one direction or another. And then there's all the wind and all the little things that affect helicopter operation. So I'm just going to do a little hover to the left here, using the pedals to keep the nose straight, a little bit of right cyclic, okay, right pedal, and as I add right pedal, I'm asking less power from the tail rotor, which means I have to roll off the throttle to keep the RPMs in the green band. I told you it was complicated. Doing a little bit more left cyclic here. There we go. So now, the other thing to keep in mind, all of this applies as you're hovering. When you're flying in straight and level flight, it's a little bit different. And seeing as this video might be getting a little bit long, maybe we'll do that as a separate video. What I'd say is that if you have any questions, the last video I did generated a lot of really good questions, so maybe we'll do more of these videos. If you have any questions about flying a helicopter, keep in mind I'm not an instructor, I'm just the dude who owns a helicopter who likes flying it. I'm happy to answer them. So leave the comments down below, like and subscribe, yada, yada, yada. I'd make the peace sign towards you like a classic YouTuber would, but my hands are full. So thanks for watching.
Make it to North Lakewood. Departure number.
Pedal turn. Helicopter 285, pad 4, left close traffic.
Helicopter 285, pad 4, clear for takeoff.
Clear for takeoff, 285.